Hi, my name is Nico and I'm an application engineer at Endress+Hauser. In this video series, we will cover the operation of our data manager's mammograph M, RSG45, and echograph T, RSG35. Check out the show notes for links to all the other videos. In this episode, we're going to learn more about the several ways of commissioning the RSG45. We are going to learn how to perform an on-site commissioning and how to use the RSG45 web server.
Depending on the model, the device can be controlled either via the touch display or via the chalk shuttle. Let's focus on the operation with the chalk shuttle, as the operation via the touch display is just as intuitive and the menu structure is identical. Let's start by accessing the web server, which makes commissioning even easier. First of all, connect the RSG45 to a local network or directly to your computer via Ethernet. There is an even more convenient way to access the web server for your service application. If the RSG45 has not been integrated into your network yet, or you just want to access the web server on site, you can simply connect your laptop via USB to the data manager and access the web server with the service IP address. This feature is an absolute game changer, for example, for your on-site service job. With this information in hand, we can switch to a computer on the same network and access the web server from any web browser. To do this, we simply use the IP address of the device and log in with the ID admin and the password admin. For more information on user administration, please watch our video RSG45 User Management. With this setup, we can continue the commissioning on the web server or directly on the device. If you choose to continue commissioning on the device, note that it's also possible to connect the keyboard via USB for easier control.
Now we are able to commission the RSG45 in several ways. Choose your preferred option to continue with the setup in our next video, where we'll take a closer look at the configuration of the input channels.